In Cambodia, motorcycles outnumber cars 10 to 1. There were 43,000 motorcycles on the road in 1990. Now it's up to more than 2 million. But there's a downside. Motorcycle crashes represent 67% of all road deaths. Our report is part of a collaboration with the Pulitzer Center on Crisis Reporting. It comes from video journalist Steve Sapienza and is narrated by Hari Sreenivasan.
In Nam Phan, 19-year-old Chang Shelia is shopping for a motorcycle with her dad and older brother.
Today I'm buying this motorcycle and I will drive it to school.
They're a family of five and this will be their third motorcycle. They don't own a car, but like many Cambodians, thanks in part to more available small loans, cheap motorcycles, and rising incomes, they can afford the equivalent of $1,100 that this motorcycle costs. It's the case across all of Asia, where most of the world's two-wheelers are sold.
Today we have sold more than 10.
And that's before noon. 85% of all the vehicles on Cambodia's roads are motorcycles, and according to the government, they cause the majority of all accidents. Nearly 200 people die on these roads every month, up almost 20% from the year before.
We also noticed that most of them are young adults, aging from 16 to 29.
Motorcyclists are also more likely to die of a head injury because while motorcycle sales are booming, helmet sales are not. All countries in Southeast Asia have mandatory helmet laws, but the laws are lightly enforced and largely ignored.
In 2004, just around 8% of motorcycle riders that they wear helmet. But now it increased up to 65% for the driver and 9% for the passenger.
In Cambodia, historically, helmet compliance has been very low. One survey on a treacherous stretch of road north of Nam Phan showed that only 24% of drivers wore helmets during the daytime, with that figure dipping to 5% after dark. That sort of weak compliance means YouTube videos like this, featuring Cambodian youth performing daredevil stunts, all without helmets. Advocates of better helmet laws say targeted education is needed.
People, they know well about the benefit from helmet wearing. However, there were some misperceptions among them that helmet wearing are not needed for the short distance travel or maybe when they travel in low speed.
The growing numbers of child passengers prompted the Asia Injury Foundation to find ways to get affordable helmets onto small heads.
Since we started our Helmet for Kids program in 2006, we have donated around 20,000 helmets to Cambodian students, teachers, and also road users in Cambodia. We were able to build the first ever non-profit helmet factory in Vietnam. It is a factory that produces helmets at lower cost, and all the profit from helmet selling will be returned to invest in road safety. We are hoping that we will be able to build a non-profit helmet factory in Cambodia as well in the near future.
The government plans to roll out new helmet laws later this year, requiring both passengers and children to wear helmets, while riders, like our new 19-year-old owner, plunge headlong into traffic without one.
Sometimes when they buy a motorcycle, they have a helmet, and sometimes they don't. It depends on the client.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Hari Sreenivasan.